Daniel Ayo here to talk about the fastest way to edit vocals in Cubase, and it essentially boils down to this: listening faster. But what does that mean? Well, in this context, it's figuring out how to increase the playback speed like you would a YouTube video in order to listen faster. We also want to preserve the event positions if there are cuts made. Now, this trick is most effective for podcasts, voiceovers, or audiobook material, and we'll use this episode from Method Matters as an example. Let's play back a few seconds.
Fanboys can't be fair.
I mean, don't
fan
get me wrong.
Fanboys stay loyal.
True words indeed. Now, before we proceed, we need to have the ruler track set to bars and beats. We can use the dot key command to switch between bars and beats and seconds by default, but we will typically want the ruler track to be the latter in this case. So we can add another ruler track by right-clicking in the track list, selecting add ruler track, add track, drag to the top, click and select seconds or time code if you prefer. Next, we want to open the pull window with Control or Command and P, expand the audio folder, and we want to check free fins. We want to make sure that the tempo of the recorded audio matches the current project tempo, which is 120 BPM by default. We also want to make sure that the musical mode column is visible. You can go to View Attributes and tick if it's not. And I would recommend the algorithm is set to Elastic Pro Time, which is by default and the best algorithm for this task. Let's click on the audio folder, then press Control or Command and A to select all the recorded audio and click to enable musical mode. If the tempo track is active, deactivate the tempo and increase the BPM up to the point where you can still be objective. So I'll use 1.5 speed, which would be 180 BPM. I'll press enter. And if I play that back.
There were good points in the video as well. I mean,
okay, name one.
I'm a fan of Xenoblade Chronicles X, and I liked the scenario. The scene.
And if I click to enable.
You mean the Skyrim ripoff?
It's back to normal speed.
Yeah, I looked at it. And I was like, this looks like Skyrim, but with a Final Fantasy 12 skin.
So now I can edit between two speeds easily with a button click. Even better would be to assign this to a key command for a quicker A-B comparison. So let's use the new key command dialog window in Cubase 13 to do just that. If we go to edit and key commands, first let's check to see if there's a command to enable the tempo track by typing in the search command tempo track. Okay, so we have it under the transport section. If I under the key column select, or rather type T for example, that's already being used. Do I want to reassign? No, I don't. Let me click here again and try Alt T instead. So because this is modal, I don't have to close the window. I can test this immediately. Let's play and then press Alt T.
What up? We have Xenoblade Chronicles X.
This game is so, what, it's so different. One, it's like a sci-fi setting rather than the fantasy setting of Skyrim.
So now I'll play and I can flip to a faster playback with ease. And that's how to edit vocals faster in Cubase. Like, comment, share, and subscribe if this has been helpful. Take care.